Here's Marcel's boat at Barry's dock on Quadra, and then he slipped over to Campbell River to get fuel and supplies, and now he's off on a big adventure. Wow, he's way out there. He's got a long way to go. This is the first leg of his journey. Look at these mountains. Look like they're watching his progress. They're keeping a good eye on him. Yeah. Pretty cool. He's slinking right along there. He's got a good wind behind him. Boat looks pretty small way out in the middle of the chuck there. Okay, he's got a new batch of mountains looking down on him. I don't know, that might be Savory Island over there. So we passed Metal Notch a little while back. All these mountains are saying goodbye to him. Who knows when he'll ever be back? Maybe someday. But he's off to Victoria. He's got a job down there running a little ferry boat. So he's got a long way to go. But this is the first leg of his journey. From here, from Campbell River, Quadra Island actually, to Comox. That will be the first leg of his journey. And then he's going to have to wait there until the storm passes, because there's a southeaster on its way. Now, this is at Point Holmes, so he's coming around the corner to Comox. And now that's the mine on Texada Island. And this is where the wind died on him out there, and the tide changed. So he had to put the engine on for a little bit. So now he's turning into Comox, and you can see that's Texada Island there he's leaving behind. I don't know, is that a buoy out there that he's coming inside of? Probably is. He draws 3.5 feet of water, so he's got lots of room. And that's Laskeedy Island there in the background. He's whizzing right past it. Well, in front of it. Now that's Hornby Island there. Now he's coming up to Tree Island and Denman Island. So he's coming right inside the harbor. I guess that's Henry Bay in the background there. And that's Union Bay and Royston there. He's coming around the end of the spit, and now he's coming into D Dock and Comox. Well, that's a pretty nice little boat that Marcel has. It's a 26-foot Panzer. These Panzers were made in Quebec, but they had a factory out here, a boatyard or whatever you call it, that makes them in Seattle. So that's probably where this one comes from. It's a little Yanmar diesel engine in it. the hurt. I was young, not dumb. It's just big enough to live on. Got a nice little head in there. Galley. Brand new. Very slick little boat. This dock is just loaded with these big ugly fish boats that are waiting for a herring opening. I guess they gotta wait out the storm also.
Well, hello!
You made it! Okay, so do you think you can get in this spot? If you can't, there's a big spot right at the very end.
Yeah, I'll park at the end.
Okay.
Well, Marcel tied up here for the first night, plugged into shore power, and had a nice, peaceful sleep. Big, long sleep. Well, maybe not so long. He got up pretty early. And then, so I met him down at the dock here, and it's crowded with these big fish boats. But he wants to get out on one of those buoys. And then, because, you know, if he stays there too long, they're going to come and charge him moorage fee. So, but if he ties up one of those buoys, it's free. What the hell? Better watch out for these guys. So anyway, he's going to tow this skiff out there and tie up to one of those buoys and leave the boat there. Diesel engine just pops right along. It's just perfect. Board the skiff. Now the guy who owns it, he's got his sailboat on a pin out there, so he's been living on it with his girlfriend and his dog. So. Just gonna use this skiff for a little bit. Gonna tie up on the first pin he gets to. There it is there. And these things are pretty solid. Boat's gonna go nowhere once he hooks up to that. Although he did spend the night out there, you see. And then the tide was going down, 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 a real low tide. So he was slinking back, back, back as the tide went down. So He figured he was dragging on that anchor, but it was just the tide going down. And here he comes. Looks nice and peaceful, but there's a southeaster predicted coming in. This is just, there it is. You see, when the southeaster hit, he got worried. And worried about the knot. And you can see the sails, like the head sail there, is starting to unfurl. So I guess he just didn't have it tied up real tight. So one of the guys on that boat there, he owns a boat just like Marcel's, tied up over at the marina, at the Navy marina on the spit there. So he knew the boat pretty good. So anyway, what he's doing there, they're pulling the sail out and then rolling it up real tight. So they had to do it a couple times to get it just right. Yeah, you don't want those sails unfurling. Make a big problem. And then they put another bow line on to the pin there. And it's coming undone. They have to pull it out and grind it in a few times before they got it right. But then it was secure. And now here I am helping him fix that door so he can put that back on his boat and make it fit. Because when he found that thing, it was just slab with a porthole.
Looks good, Marcel.
Thanks, Paul.
It's good.
Looks like it belongs.
Looks like it belongs. The most beautiful sound I'd ever heard. Sam, eat your heart out.